Hey guys, so for today, what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take you through a bit of a walkthrough on how I do my listing videos. Every time I have a client, we're putting up listing, I like to do my own video. I have a lot more control that way, and it's something that I've always enjoyed doing. So today, you guys get to come along with this and watch me do it. Okay, we'll see you in there.
Okay, so basically what I'm doing here, so I'm just doing the slow pull-in of this nice dining area. I wanna keep it nice and wide. That's why I'm using the 18 millimeter here. I just want to highlight some of the best parts. So we'll do the kitchen, we'll do the living room, we'll do some of the upstairs as well. Just gonna move in nice and smooth. Show off this awesome space. What I'll usually do, I'll come in from one angle and then I'll just do another angle just so people get more of a view. Hello. Try to do as many corners as I can, just to show off the entire space. Gives everybody sort of a full view. And there's kind of a rule where you don't want to kind of jump from one side completely to the other side. It's like a, I think they call it the 180 degree rule. And I break it all the time. But honestly, I think it doesn't really matter as much in real estate. But we'll try to show off as much as we can here. Make it a little bit cinematic if I can. And then a lot of times what I'll do is I'll film myself going up the stairs. And then I'll show off a space, and then I'll oftentimes ramp up the speed so that when I come up, you don't have to go me slowly going up the stairs. It kind of swiftly goes up the stairs and then it smooths out, which is really nice. So right now we're rocking the 5D Mark IV, and I tend to shoot in usually like a 4 aperture. I do that because it allows me to kind of get more in focus rather than being at like fully wide open. And then like, if you're coming up against something, then you might like get just the tip of this in focus. And then as you move out, it kind of takes a little bit more time. So I usually shoot in a 4. That just makes it so that I'm a little bit safer. It's pretty bright in here. I've done some stuff in some dungeons before, and you do have to be wide open for those. But when I can, I will try to shoot in about 4. And I'm shooting at 60 frames a second so that when I move in, I can go about this fast. And then when I put it on the timeline to edit it, I'll turn it to 24 frames a second, so half-ish. And that just smooths everything out. It looks really buttery, really pretty. Usually what I'll try to do is I'll try to go past an object. That gives it space, so like I'll try to go past the banister. Rather than just starting here and going in, there's not much happening, I'll go past the banister. Makes it look nicer. Okay, so I'll kind of sort of show you the master bedroom here. It's super gorgeous. What a pretty home. The ensuite is kind of all in one here. So when I'm filming it, I'm gonna come straight into this ensuite behind you guys right now. And it's gonna look gorgeous. I mean, who wouldn't wanna live in a place like this? Look at that. Okay, we are pretty much all done here. Lori's hitting all the lights. We're gonna wrap it up. But it's been a really awesome shoot here in this gorgeous home. I think we're looking at almost 3,300 square feet, so huge. All right, I'll see you in a minute. All right, so now that we're done shooting, I'll bring all the gear back home, get the video onto Final Cut, edit it there, send it off to the client. And to be honest, the editing part is one of my favorite parts of the whole process. You get to create something new, which is really fun. And I would love to walk you through my editing process at some point in the future if you guys are interested. But for now, let's take a look at the final video. Pretty much does it. You've seen how I like to shoot my listing videos, a little bit of the final product there. So if you want to see more of these vlog type videos, I'm totally down to do more. So like the video, feel free to subscribe, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye.